I'm Darren McKeown. I'm the author of All That Is Solid Melts Into Air. It's a book that is set in the Soviet Union in 1986 and 1987. And it's about a group of people whose lives are coming apart as the Soviet system falls around them. Mostly the book is set in Chernobyl, and it deals with the Chernobyl incident. And I was very drawn to the idea of Chernobyl or the event of Chernobyl because actually I met a group of school children who would have come to my town when I was 12 or 13. I'm from Ireland. I'm from a small town in the middle of Ireland, which might sound like an unusual choice for an Irish author. But I was very drawn to these children that I met, and they were some of the first foreigners I'd ever encountered. And I became very curious about their lives. And then later on, when I was 17 or 18, I saw a documentary on Chernobyl. And I was very intrigued about the people who had moved back to farm the land around the reactor. And my father is a farmer, and I understood that connection with the land. And over time, I began to write about the people. And once I began to research the subject, it became compelling. And I also found that through my research, I found that Mikhail Gorbachev has said actually that it was kind of the beginning of the end, that Chernobyl was the point that accelerated the end of the Soviet Union. So very quickly it became a bigger novel. It became a novel about the end of a system or the end of a political system. And one of the things I wanted to get across in the book was the idea of the distortion of nature, how nature around the plant became just, actually quite surreal. So there were forests in the area that turned autumnal overnight. Very strange, two-headed animals were being born in the forest. And that sense of nature really becoming distorted, I wanted to kind of bring that into some of my characters. So Yevgeny's 9 years old, he lives in Moscow, and his sense of rhythm is beginning to deteriorate, and he's a piano prodigy. So he's a character that I deal with, and then he has an aunt called Maria, who's a dissident journalist, who's been forced to work in a car parts factory just outside Moscow. And they're related to a surgeon who's been sent to the Chernobyl zone. And he really gives a strong sense, or I certainly tried with him to give a strong sense of how out of his depth he was, how this was an accident that the world had never encountered before. I was also really drawn to the testimony about people who lived in the city of Pripyat and who lived around the plant, how they actually, in the evening of the accident, came out into their balconies and looked at the beautiful sky that was emanating from around the plant. And the whole accident has a terrible beauty to it, and a very kind of quiet beauty to it as well, even though it is terrifying and horrific in many ways. And so it was a place that I became just very intrigued in the sense of an ending of a political system, the kind of atmosphere of the Soviet Union in those days. Once you read about the history of the place, you can feel something beginning to tear itself apart. And how that related to people on a day-to-day level, people's lives who were directly affected by the accident and also indirectly affected. So the book that means a lot to me and that I keep returning to is Underworld by Don DeLillo. And it's a book that I read when I was about 18 or 19. And my previous experience of reading, I'm from Ireland, so I would have read a lot of Irish authors up till then. Writing about Ireland, it's quite a local, Ireland is a small country, so most novels that I had encountered were very kind of localized novels. And novels written in a vernacular that was very familiar to me. And I think reading Underworld expanded my idea of, or my conception of what the novel could be. I think I would have been a writer without reading it, but I think it definitely made me a particular kind of writer. There's a certain kind of elasticity to the book, that it kind of expands and contracts in various ways. And it really does tell the story of half a century of a country's life through the two very specific characters and through a very specific atmosphere. And I do think that even 15 or 20 years after I've read it, I still think Don DeLillo can write the best sentences of any writer alive, I think.